Lance, if I were to have a grower, which I do, come to me and ask me about how to start an IPM program, I tell him it's a combination of a lot of things. Sanitation, certainly scouting. You have to have an excellent scouting program and be proactive and not reactive. Then they have to, as you mentioned, there are chemicals that you've got to stop using. There are certain chemicals that are, what are the lengths of time that it'll kill?
Some of them are 3 to 4 months.
3 to 4 months before.
After the last application.
Absolutely.
And you can run into problems even with the residue in the tank. If you haven't cleaned out your tanks well and spray that another chemical that's safe, you can still kill the predators just from the residue that's in the tank. So you have to start at ground zero. You look at this nursery and you could almost eat off the floor. It's clean. Okay, so when I walk into
a place... We knew you were coming.
Yeah. Now, I've been here before. But the bottom line is that it's a combination of things. You have to be clean. I can look at this crop. I don't see any mites on it right now. That's the time to start the program. You don't start when you're already losing crop and you're panicked. No. And that's the biggest problem we have. We have growers come in, says, I can't kill them with chemicals. I'm going to lose the crop. Can I use biocontrol? And it doesn't work.
No, it's a lifestyle of growing, is what it is.
And we tell these growers, you know, you don't try to do your whole crop. You, if anything, you even start on just 3 or 4 plants. Get a few predators and teach yourself how these things work. Okay, learn about, you know, if I put them on today, what's going to happen tomorrow? How do I recognize what a predator looks like? How do I recognize what a predator egg looks like? How do I know when a dead mite is there, whether a predator's eaten it or that sort of thing? And start going to, we have conferences all the time, all over the country, on how to use biological controls. Start simple, go slow, teach yourself so you're confident, so you know what to expect. And you make sure that you have communication between the person that's scouting all the way up to the top, so everybody's on the same page. And that's how you start it.
It takes a commitment. You have to be committed to it to make it work. But to make it work, speed bumps in your way, they're not mountains.
Yep.
They can be done.